I offer this podcast with a strong disclaimer right up front that I do not endorse or condone any of the actions that I'm going to describe here as an analysis of events that look likely to happen in what's being called a Civil War II scenario. And these events, if they do happen, will result in the loss of life for probably millions of people. And of course, I always hope for peace and I always hope for civility. But what has become clear now in the aftermath of the Robert Mueller report, the collapse of the Russia collusion hoax, is that the deranged lunatic left in America today simply cannot coexist with anyone with whom they disagree. They cannot accept facts that they don't like. They cannot accept outcomes that they don't want. I mean, these are the same people in 2015, they said, we all have to accept the outcome of the 2016 election. And then after the 2016 election, they said, we don't accept the outcome of the 2016 election. And then in 2018, they said, we all have to accept the outcome of the Robert Mueller report. And then in 2019, when the report comes out, they say, we don't accept the outcome of the Robert Mueller report. Leftists are frauds. They're con artists. They are lawless. They respect no law, no civility, and you cannot coexist with people like this. They are going to drive our country to a civil war. In fact, it has already begun. They are lawless. Look at how their laws never apply to them. Jussie Smollett gets off. Hillary Clinton, not prosecuted. You know, they fabricate fake accusations against President Trump and try to get him arrested for treason, which carries the death penalty, by the way, and they abuse their power to do it. These deep state left-wing operatives, including Barack Obama and Hillary Clinton and James Comey and others, even Robert Mueller himself, are all guilty of treason. And when caught, they still will not apologize. The media won't apologize. They won't retract any of the 500,000 fake news articles. And the tech giants won't stop their censorship. They're doubling down. Facebook just said they're going to censor everybody who is a white Trump supporter. Yep, they created this new term, white nationalist. It's a bigoted smear. It's a slur. It's like the N-word, but directed to white people. White nationalist just means somebody who's white, who loves their country, loves America. It just means that you're a patriot who salutes the American flag and loves what America stands for, loves the Constitution. If you happen to be white, you are now going to be banned on Facebook because this is how these leftists play. They abide by no rules. They are going to drive this country to a civil war. Now, I published a detailed analysis at newstarget.com. You can read more there, but here's the gist of it. Liberals live in cities for the most part. Cities are like liberal meccas, but cities are extremely vulnerable. Cities depend on artificial inputs and exports in order to survive. For example, a city without electricity is no city at all. It's a death trap. It's worse than a third world nation. It's a collapsed cesspool of filth and violence, crime, right? So electricity comes to the cities from rural areas. In fact, all the inputs that come to cities come to them from rural areas. Water comes to the cities from outside the cities. Electricity and food. And then cities export things like raw sewage sludge. Every city in America, as I documented in my recent film, Biosludged, every city is exporting its sewage sludge to rural areas and dumping it on farms and forests out in rural America. Now, again, as a disclaimer, I don't advocate any of this. I'm trying to analyze what may be happening and give you a warning here to get out of the cities because as a civil war unfolds, it's almost certain. And Matt Bracken agrees with me. He's at AmericanPartisan.org. I cited his article in my article. Matt Bracken says that it's inevitable, if this happens, that the patriots, those who are defending America, will simply take out the power grid substations that are outside the cities. It's not even that difficult, actually. I mean, these power substations are unguarded. There's no defense. Mostly it's just chain link fences. And they're incredibly easy for someone to take out if that would be their goal because parts are hard to get. You don't even have to, apparently, you don't have to destroy it in person. I mean, there were cases in the past of people shooting some of these components from quite a long distance. I mean, rifle fire can reach these components. You know, an electrical substation can be taken down from, you know, a couple thousand yards away. No one even has to be there. So they're extremely vulnerable from a tactical analysis point of view. And again, I have to reiterate, I absolutely do not advocate anyone taking down the power grid, because the loss of life would be severe. But people who live in liberal cities need to understand that this is such an Achilles heel. It's such an obvious strategic point that if a civil war gets underway, it's a no-brainer that patriotic Americans are going to disconnect probably the power grid from the liberal cities. And when that happens, I want you to imagine, I mean, take a look at LA, Los Angeles. The entire water supply depends on the power supply. You take out the power grid, there's no water. But there's also, of course, no communications. There's no EBT cards, no food stamps. You would have rioting and gang warfare in the streets of LA in less than 48 hours. And there aren't enough cops to deal with that. There aren't even enough cops in LA to deal with the day-to-day shootings in LA. Can you imagine a collapse scenario? The cops would be outnumbered 100-1, easy. It would not be a good scenario. LA would collapse into third world status. Now, why would liberal cities be targeted, probably, in a civil war? This is an analysis. Well, because liberal cities contain the propaganda fake news media organizations that have already attempted to commit treason against America by pushing the Russia collusion hoax for over 2 years. All those offices of the New York Times, the LA Times, the CNN, you know, MSNBC, all of them are in liberal cities. And at the same time, the tech giants, you know, all the tech companies that have engaged in extreme censorship, censoring people because they are conservatives, censoring pro-America voices, engaging in election fraud, as Google has already been proven to do. All these tech companies also, their server farms depend on electricity, and they are in liberal cities, all of them. So if electricity is taken out to these liberal cities, then what gets taken out is the media and the big tech giants that are censoring patriotic Americans. I mean, all at once. And what you end up doing, actually, if this were to happen, is these cities would be plunged into starvation and disease just by blocking their export of their biosludge, which is the raw sewage, right? Just by blocking the exports of that, making them dump their own, sorry to say, pardon my language, but making cities dump their own shit in their own backyard, that alone would unleash mass disease, E. coli, cholera, and many other conditions all across the cities. Just make them live in their own shit. And that's what would happen. Right now, they dump that on the countryside and they sicken rural people, but they don't give a crap about that. They're city people. They flush it and they think it's gone. They forget about it. So when this unravels, if it does, in this way, the reason I'm warning people about this is because you don't want to be in the cities, especially if you are a patriot, because there could be, you know, so-called friendly fire. You could end up in a grid down scenario, even though you support America. And in my opinion, I mean, you make up your own mind about this, obviously, but in my opinion, you've got about 18 months to get out of the city, because the election of 2020 is coming up and it's going to be contested no matter who wins or loses. I see the election of 2020 as a very likely tipping point to push this country into open conflict, outbreak of civil war. It can happen following the election, because think about it, if Trump wins, then the insane, deranged left, of course, they will fabricate a whole new excuse. Oh, it wasn't the Russians this time. It was the Chinese stole the election. You know, they'll come up with something. And then if the Democrats win the election, they can only do so by committing fraud, ballot harvesting, election fraud, having illegals vote, you know, stealing the popular vote with that compact they have. They can only win by fraud. And the conservatives will not accept a Democrat president if they win by fraud. So this is going to get dicey no matter what, and you should be prepared. I urge you, think about getting out of the city, because the vulnerabilities of the cities the electrical power grid vulnerability is so obvious that in a civil war scenario, that's going to be one of the first targets. And if you're stuck in a place like Chicago without power in the winter, you know, the 2020/2021 winter, not going to be a pretty scene. Or if you're stuck in a city like Houston with no power in the summer, not going to be pretty. It's going to be bad. So get prepared. I call for peace. I call for the left to apologize. I call for the media to be dismantled, all those who lied, all those who pushed the attempted coup, all those who committed treason, including journo terrorists, should be arrested and prosecuted for treason. Deep state people need to go to jail. Barack Obama, Hillary Clinton need to be arrested and incarcerated. And every journalist who pushed that media lie needs to resign permanently from journalism and issue a national apology. And Democrats need to be banned from all elections for 4 years. I would accept that as a sufficient apology. Maybe they could learn to coexist if they would simply do something like that. But they are not interested in coexisting. They are not interested in following the law. Leftists are lunatics. They are mass mentally ill. They follow no rules, no laws, and they hate America, and they want to see America destroyed, overrun. They want to see a civil war under President Trump, and that's why they're pushing everything toward civil war. This is what they want. This is who they are. They are evil people. We have to defeat them, but they're going to try to get us shooting at each other first. It's very clear that's what they're trying to do. Pray for America, call for peace, but be ready for anything. Read my website, survival.news. I've also got another website, civilwar.news. This is Mike Adams. Thank you for listening. When you support us, we keep fighting for America. We keep fighting for your liberty, fighting for your natural health, for disease prevention, for education and knowledge about how to be healthy and how to live a productive, happy life. Support us at healthrangerstore.com. Over 700 products. Lab tested, clean, ultra clean, the cleanest offered anywhere in the world. HealthRangerStore.com. Check it out. Support our mission and help enhance and protect your health at the same time. Thank you for watching. If you want to support our mission, visit us at HealthRangerStore.com for the world's largest selection of lab verified superfood and nutritional products for healthy living. It's at HealthRangerStore.com.